Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is the first Friday of December. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. The Lord speaks of peace to His people and His holy ones and to those who turn to Him.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Clothe us, Lord God, with the virtues of the heart of your Son, and set us aflame with his love, that conformed to his image, we may merit a share in eternal redemption. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. In a vision, I, Daniel, saw during the night the four winds of heaven stirred up the great sea, from which emerged four immense beasts, each different from the others. The first was like a lion, but with eagle's wings. While I watched, the wings were plucked. It was raised from the ground to stand on 2 feet like a man and given a human mind. The second was like a bear. It was raised up on one side, and among the teeth in its mouth were three tusks. It was given the order, "Up, devour much flesh." After this, I looked and saw another beast, like a leopard. On its back were four wings like those of a bird, and it had four heads. To this beast dominion was given. After this, in the visions of the night, I saw the fourth beast, different from all the others, terrifying, horrible, and of extraordinary strength. It had great iron teeth with which it devoured and crushed, and what was left it trampled with its feet. I was considering the 10 horns it had, when suddenly another, a little horn, sprang out of their midst, and 3 of the previous horns were torn away to make room for it. This horn had eyes like a man, and a mouth that spoke arrogantly. As I watched, thrones were set up, and the Ancient One took his throne. His clothing was snow bright, and the hair on his head as white as wool. His throne was flames of fire with wheels of burning fire. A surging stream of the fire flowed out from where he sat. Thousands upon thousands were ministering to him, and myriads upon myriads attended him. The court was convened and the books were opened. I watched then from the first of the arrogant words which the horn spoke, until the beast was slain and its body thrown into the fire to be burnt up. The other beasts, which also lost their dominion, were granted a prolongation of life for a time and a season. And the visions during the night continued. I saw one like a son of man coming on the clouds of heaven. When he reached the Ancient One and was presented before him, he received dominion, glory, and kingship. Nations and peoples of every language serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Give glory and eternal praise to God.
Give glory and eternal praise to him.
Mountains and hills bless the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever.
Give glory and eternal praise to him.
Everything growing from the earth, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever.
Give glory and eternal praise to him.
You springs, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever.
Give glory and eternal praise to him.
Seas and rivers, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever.
Give glory and eternal praise to him.
You dolphins and all water creatures, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever.
Give glory and eternal praise to him.
All you birds of the air, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever.
give glory and eternal praise to Him.
All you beasts, wild and tame, bless the Lord, praise and exalt Him above all forever.
Give glory and eternal praise to Him.
Alleluia, Alleluia. Stand erect and raise your heads because your redemption is at hand. Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus told His disciples a parable. Consider the fig tree and all the other trees. When their buds burst open, you see for yourselves and know that summer is now near. In the same way, when you see these things happening, know that the kingdom of God is near. Amen, I say to you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So we are on our two final days now of the liturgical year. Of course, the main theme now again is readiness, no, today and tomorrow. And Sunday now is the first Sunday of Advent. No? So maybe just for today, I'd like to invite you to reflect on three points with regard to readiness. No? And tomorrow, we will continue this theme of readiness, no, and going more on a more personal level. Although even today is a very personal, you might say, points for consideration, no? But more so tomorrow. The first is the ability to read the signs of the times. No, that's the first point that we will reflect on. And then the second is, again, going back, renewing our prayer life. No, so that's the second point that I invite you to reflect on. And then the third point is related to prayer life, is perhaps to consider renewing our use of scripture, of sacred scripture, and then our devotion, especially our devotion to the Mass. No? So these three points to reflect on. First, about the ability to read the signs of the times. No, here you see Christ saying that. No, He says, no, you consider the fig tree and all the other trees. No, when their buds burst open, you see for yourselves and know that summer is near. No, in the same way, you see these things happening, know the kingdom of God is near. Here the Lord is saying, no, there is a certain rhythm. No, there's a certain rhythm in nature. And for us, we read that. No? In fact, one of the most interesting things, no, when I was studying abroad, is the Farmer's Almanac. No, and there, no, they really read the signs and movements and the cycles of nature. No, and I think the Lord is saying the same. No, if we are able to read, no, the cycles of nature, of human life, if you wish, then He's reminding us that it's also, we can also read, no, the movements of the Spirit, no, and the visitations of God in our life. No, these are the signs of the times that we must learn to read. No, so maybe that first point to reflect on. No, have we in a sense sharpened, no, our ability to discern the movements of the spirits in our day-to-day life, the presence of God? Are we able to see that, no, in our day-to-day life? So this first point to reflect on. No. And second, related to the ability to see the signs of the times and the movement of the Spirit, is prayer life. No, remember what we always mention about prayer life. It is to waste time with God. No, it is really to be in the presence of God. And when you think about it, even on a very human level, when we are present to each other, we get to know each other more. No, in a very authentic way. No, we do not impose our concepts or our biases on a person, but if we are openly present to each other, and that is prayer, no, being present to God, no, suspending our biases, if you wish, no, our preconceived notions, and allowing God to be God, no, and then we are able to know Him more in our lives, no, His movement in our lives. So the second point, no, very important to reading the signs of the times, is developing a very genuine and authentic prayer life, no. And then the third and final point is, again, related to prayer and spirituality. No, it is developing our devotion, if you wish, no, to two important elements of our faith, the Eucharist and then Scripture. That's why the Mass, the daily Mass, is divided into the liturgy of the Word and the liturgy of the Eucharist. No, so I think this daily devotion to the Mass really, in a sense, helps us understand Scripture more, hopefully. And then also it helps us develop a devotion to Holy Scripture. And then also a devotion to the Mass. Because these are two These are two gifts to us, no, channels of grace, no, for us to deepen our faith life and ultimately to deepen our relationship with God, no. So we pray for that also, no. So siguro maganda, no, itong dalawang huling araw ng ating taon ng liturhiya, bukas sa Linggo, no, magsisimula tayo ng panibagong taon ng liturhiya, ay sana ay mapalalim natin, ano, ang ating kakayahan. Sabi nga ng Panginoon, kung nababasa ninyo ang nangyayari, no, sa kalikasan, no, na pag nag ano, pag dumating yung itong panahon na ito, alam mo, mag-uusbong ang mga puno, magbubunga yan, etc., no. Sabi nga niya, no, nababasa natin ang galaw ng kalikasan. Mahalaga na mabasa rin natin ang galaw ng Espiritu, no, sa ating buhay. Ang presensya at galaw ng Diyos sa ating mga buhay. Yun nga yung tinatawag na, you know, pagkakayahan natin basahin, ano, ang signos, no, ng panahon, ang signos ng ating pang-araw-araw na buhay. Siguro yung unang punto na yan, ano. At kaugnay nito, yung pangalawang punto, papaano ba natin mapapatalas, ano, ang ating kakayahang makilatis, no, o mabasa ang paggalaw ng Espiritu? Buhay panalangin, ano. Sabi nga natin, di ba, ang panalangin ay ang pananahan sa presensya ng Diyos, no. Sabi nga ni Father Arupe, yung mag-waste time with God, di ba? Kahit sa mga kaibigan natin, yung mga malapit nating pamilya, kaibigan, mahalaga, di ba, na tayo ay nagsasama-sama. Meron tayong panahon sa isa't isa, no? Yung walang agenda ba na pagiging present to one another, magsama na walang agenda, kundi just to enjoy each other's company, no? Magalak tayo na kasama lang natin yung mga kaibigan, mga mahal natin sa buhay. Lumalalim ang ating pagkilala, no, sa isa't isa. At yung pangatlo at huling punto ay ang ating debosyon sa Santa Misa at sa Banal na Kasulatan. Kaya makikita natin, 'di ba, sa Misa, dalawang bahagi. Yung una ay liturhiya ng salita, ng banal na salita. Ang pangalawa ay liturhiya ng Eukaristiya, no? Na yan ay pagpapalalim ng debosyon at pagpapalalim din ng ating ugnayan sa Diyos, no? Siguro ngayon sa huling dalawang araw, ang ganda nga, weekend, ano, meron tayong panahon magnilay at magdasal. Magbalik tanaw tayo, no, sa nakaraang taon. Let us look back at the past year, no, as we enter the Advent season and prepare for Christmas and the New Year. Let us ask ourselves, no, how we have deepened our prayer life, our relationship with God, and our ability, no, to discern His presence in our day-to-day life. The Lord Jesus has called us to watch for the day of His return. Let us come to the Father in prayer, watching and waiting for His return.
That the Church may respond to the call for conversion and renewal, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That people of goodwill may work together to put an end to war and hatred, oppression and injustice, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may increase our awareness of the presence of Christ among the poor and the suffering people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass, continuing to pray for peace in our world and joining our prayers with the Holy Father. And let's also pray for the Holy Father. For all this, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O God, Father of mercies, who, because of the great love with which you loved us, with untold goodness gave us your only begotten Son, grant, we pray, that being perfectly united with Him, we may offer you worthy homage through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For raised up high on the cross, he gave himself up for us with a wonderful love and poured out blood and water from his pierced side, the wellspring of the Church's sacraments, so that won over to the open heart of the Savior, all might draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together let us offer Pope Francis's prayer for peace.
Lord, God of peace, King of heaven and earth, hear our prayer. We have tried so many times and over so many years to resolve our conflicts by our own powers and by the force of our arms. How many moments of hostility and darkness have we experienced? How much blood has been shed? How many lives have been shattered? How many hopes have been buried? But our efforts have been in vain. Now, Lord, come to our aid. Grant us peace, teach us peace, guide our steps in the way of peace. Open our eyes and our hearts, and give us the courage to say, never again war. With war, everything is lost. Instill in our hearts the courage to take concrete steps to achieve peace. Lord God of love, you created us and you call us to live as brothers and sisters. Give us the strength daily to be instruments of peace. Enable us to see everyone who crosses our path as our brother or sister. Make us sensitive to the plea of our citizens who entreat us to turn our weapons of war into implements of peace, our trepidation into confident trust, and our quarreling into forgiveness. Keep alive within us the flame of hope, so that with patience and perseverance, we may opt for dialogue and reconciliation. In this way, we may peace triumph at last, and may the words division, hatred, and war be banished from the heart of every man and woman. Lord, diffuse the violence of our tongues in our hands. Renew our hearts and minds so that the word which always brings us together will be brother, sister, and our way of life will always be that of shalom, peace, salam. Amen. Our Lady, Queen of Peace, pray for us.
And let us pray. Made partakers in your sacrament of charity, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that we may be conformed to Christ on earth and merit to be co-heirs of his glory in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat. And reminder, on Sunday is the first Sunday of Advent. So at the beginning of the Mass, we will bless your Advent wreath. We will bless your Advent candles if you have at home. So please prepare them and we will bless them at the beginning of the Sunday Mass for the first Sunday of Advent. No? And again, have a good day ahead. Have a good weekend. And let's have a prayerful weekend to prepare for Advent and Christmas. Maraming pong salamat. This Christmas, let us bring the love of Christ to many Filipino families
by sharing whatever we can to alay kapwa.
Ano man ang kaya, biyaya sa iba. Ito ang ating alay kapwa.
Sa lahat ng ating mga kapatid, maligayang Pasko po. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to all.
Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.